go around. What do you got? He's like, a dozen long stems. You want them? I said, how much are they? He says, 50 bucks a stem. I said, let me see what I've got. I pull my pocket, I'm looking for my wallet. My cousin runs over. What are you guys doing? I said, well, I'm buying some long stems. He says, how much are they? 50 bucks a stem. He says, he's ripping you off. Don't pay for it. I look at my cousin like he's insane. And I say to him, my whole life I've been waiting to buy her the roses, and now I'm not going to buy it for her. The keeper looks out, this tall medium, and he explains. Life is about one thing, which is why when we fail at this, it causes such severe damage. Life is about honor. My whole life I've been waiting to fulfill the verse. I've been waiting to give everything. And now I'm not going to give it. And Rabbi Akiva closes his eyes. And he begins to tell the Ribono Shel Olam, you're everything. Shema Yisrael. Soul goes out with the word. I said to my Rebbe, it's not fair! It's not fair! Everybody said, what? What's wrong? He never got to finish the line. He never got to say the key word. Hashem Echad, he's one, he's unity, he's Abba. He never got to say the word. Why was he deprived? My Rebbe said back to me, man, every single mitzvah is an exercise to build a muscle. There's a goal. The halacha b'drach that you should become like God. He achieved the goal. There wasn't a need for one more syllable. Regarding Ava, Rabbi Akiva was like in Ribono Shel Olam Kabbalah. The angels in heaven cried out, and they said, Zoo Torah is a skara! This is Torah, this is reward! At 40, the man turns his whole life upside down for this! And he said, it doesn't say that. I said, Rabbi, I'm looking at the Gemara. Zoo Torah is a skara! He said, wait, that's not what it says. It says, the angels in heaven cried out. And the angels of heaven said, oh, they said, oh, Zu Torah, this is Torah. It's a system for building a system for becoming mature, for escaping babyhood. Zu Torah, Zu Sarah. And this is your reward. If all you want is Ava, you just want to give, Hashem will bring you a person to give to. And if you give and you give and you give, and you build that muscle further, Hashem will bring you children. I guarantee that. Biological or adopted. There are millions and millions of children on planet Earth, aged 0 to 120, who need you to adopt them. You want to give to somebody you want to love? There are plenty and plenty of people to take care of. And if you give to that special one that Hashem gives you, you give to children, then Hashem will give you more schar. He might give you neighbors. He might give you a neighborhood. He might give you an entire city. He might give you an entire country. In Rabbi Akiva's case, he gave you the whole world, the God of the door. Zutor is Luskar. If all you want is to give, Hashem will give you the reward for that. He'll give you the opportunity. The angel said, we get it. A voice called out from the heavens and said, welcome, Rabbi Akiva. You've been invited into the front row. You achieved the purpose of a human life. You're a model for all of Klal Yisrael, and more than that. You are a successful warrior against the culture of selfishness. Suicide is forbidden, because suicide falls in the category of Baal Tashchis. It is needless recreational destruction. And you are not allowed for fun to even smash a chair, let alone take a human life, even your own. Needless destruction is forbidden. But a valiant soldier who runs into battle to fight for his cause, knowing that he will die but his cause will be triumphant, that's not called suicide, that's called heroism. And Rabbi Akiva fired the last shot of his generation against that culture of selfishness, and he triumphed, and the proof is. But here, in year 2016, a couple of hours from where they tore Rabbi Akiva to shreds, in the amphitheater in Caesarea, we are still talking about him. And we are still learning the lesson that Rabbi Akiva came to teach us, which is the only thing that counts is Ahava. So, as I leave you, I'll just point out that the 3 weeks can be such confusing times. There's so many different observances, there's so many different subtexts and themes that run through this 3 week period. But, like everything in Torah, it can be boiled down to a klal. And the klal is that we want to become heroes. We want to become great people. We want to fulfill our purpose on planet Earth. And the way that we do that is by building a desire to give and to let go of what I want for the sake of someone else. Shalom Guf, my spouse, and above all, Ribono Shalom, who loves us so much and just wants us to join him in that relationship. You know, we should be successful, each and every one of us, and through your efforts, we should see the Korban turned into a